Hello and welcome to the channel YouTube world, another daily Mountain Blade 2 update, link in the description as always. So we're now on 1.0.10. Fixed a rare crash that occurred when players created their own kingdom in the main storyline. Fixed a crash with the text management system, or that happens when attacking a besieged settlement after an external interruption to the world map siege occurs. Or that happens when attacking hideouts after leaving during the attack and returning to the preparation. Fixed a bug that made the escort merchant caravan quests remaining days an unreasonable number. Fixed a bug that occurred when determining opposition kingdoms in the main storyline. Fixed a cloth simulation issue which reduced frames per second in big battles. Fixed a flickering issue with flag marker UI elements. That's pretty much it. So on the little bit smaller side of an update, but I really do appreciate these daily updates. Again, I want to remind people every time, sound like a broken record, but this could be the first time you see my videos. Remember your launcher. Oh no, I'm still on 1.0.0. Oh no, that's okay. These are the ones here, the sandbox core, the sandbox, the story mode, the custom battles. That's what's getting updated, not the native. Okay, so don't worry about that. Again, when you load your game and you go to a save, oh no, why does it say 1.0.8.9 or any other version but what's listed there? It's because you haven't loaded the game with the newest modules yet, which is why when you go and you load a saved game, it'll say that there's a module mismatch. Do you want to proceed and load the modules? In other words, do you want to apply the updates to your existing save? You click yes. In a perfect scenario, everything will carry over. Like, everything will be applied to your update. Again, is it possible that something slips through the crack and doesn't quite work and something is still bugged? Sure, I'm not denying that that can't happen. It is early access, after all. And I've tried on a couple of occasions now to start a game fresh. So every time there's a new update, I start a fresh save. I use a trainer to get all the gold in the world, you know what I'm saying? And I just kind of mess around and just kind of check things out to get caught up to speed with where my legit save is. And I'm not noticing myself any benefit to doing that. I'm still on my original save from the very first day. And is it perfect? Well, of course not. It's early access. I know some people have been complaining too, why so many updates? I'd rather just see like one good big update. Well, what's the difference between me giving you $7 a week or $1 a day? It still works out to be the same. I like to see a little bit of something every single day because it results in the same thing, really. And it shows you how hard they're working. I mean, find me another game in early access where devs are just like, wow, every single day. They even have like a nice thumbnail. I could be downloading the thumbnails, for crying out loud, to their patch. It's always a different picture. I'm just saying, like, they really, look at that, 1.10987, like, they're not messing around. These aren't people that are going to abandon us. Watch someday, there's like no update for, heaven forbid, 24 hours, and everybody's in a panic. Hey, how come there's no update? Did they abandon us? Did they quit the project? No, they won't do that. These are, I mean, I don't know them, but from what I've seen and just know, they seem like an incredible team. Again, the early access, in my opinion, it was a little expensive, I'm not gonna lie, but I don't like talking about pricing on anything because I am a poor bastard. So it's kind of like, am I being biased because I'm poor? Or am I legitimately saying something is expensive, because it truly is expensive? For an early access, there's no denying at full price Canadian, I think it's like $65. That's not a cheap early access game. Do I think it should be free or $10? No, right? Because then when it gets fully released, right, it usually doesn't quite work out that way. I do think you should get some sort of compensation. And because I own the first Mountain Blade, Bannerlord? No, Mountain Blade. I forget what it was called. But the point is I got an additional 10% on top of the 10%. So I got 20% off. So I pay like $45-ish Canadian. So probably like $37, $35 American. It's not terrible. I personally think it should have just been half the price. I think it should have been like 30 American. For me, 30 American. It's easy for me to start throwing numbers around. But anyways, no one needs to hear me rambling on for half hour or an hour, or God only knows, up to 2.5 hours when I live stream. You don't want to tune in for that. And that's why most people don't. But yeah, so if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Again, if you didn't like the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs down. And I'll make sure the next time you leave your house, this guy here on the horse, oh yeah, he's not going to be practicing social distancing. No. Well, actually, he might. The horse won't, because he's gonna bite your nutsack off. And then after that, you're going to get speared in the head. And that was a little gruesome, but yeah, you get the idea. If you want to subscribe to the channel, naturally, that would be great. And if not, thanks for stopping by anyways. Take care, boys and girls, or whatever it is you identify as. Stay safe. Be happy. And play some Mountain Blade. Share with me your experiences. I do try and respond as much as I can. I'm such a tiny rinky-dink YouTuber. But you would be surprised the amount of comments I get on a daily basis. It's almost a part-time job in its own. It's kind of very incredible. So if I don't reply to you, know that I more than likely saw your comment, just didn't always quite get a chance to physically reply to you. But I see you. Okay, that's enough from me. Bye. See you later.